Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I'm going to follow up on a promise. I promised you that we were going to talk about this Codon version, or Codon version of this Game of Life simulator for Python and how it compares to the C++ version. But I did say that I had to record an additional episode before I could get there, so hopefully you have watched the episode on modulus, because that becomes very important in this episode of C++ Weekly. For review, I have a bunch of different versions of a Game of Life simulator written in C++ and Python mixed with C++, and we tested them against Python with a JIT, regular Python, all the things. Okay, I'm going to do a quick recompile of the C++ version. We have our fixed up version of the regular life.py, which moved the neighbors out of the count neighbors function and moved it into the automata class so that it is not reconstructed every single time we go to count the neighbors. And then that brings us to Codon. We should mention what Codon is. By their own definition, Codon is a high-performance Python compiler that compiles Python code to native machine code without any runtime overhead. Typical speedups over Python are on the order of 10 to 100 times or more on a single thread. It is typically on par with and sometimes better than that of C and C++. Like Python, Codon supports native multi-threading, which can lead to speedups. Now, I'm going to say I'm barely scratching the surface of this project because it supports all kinds of things, such as magic built-in GPU kernels, and that would be absolutely amazing, but we're not going to touch on that in this episode. We just need to look at the version of our Game of Life simulator that works with Codon. It took some porting. It is not directly Python. We have to give types. We have to tell it that this point class has an X and a Y, fine, that are both integers. For some functions, we don't have to, but for classes, we do. It's a lot like C++ in this regard. It has to know what kind of class it's creating, how big it is, and what types it contains. But otherwise, the logic stays exactly the same. So let's run a quick test here. First of all, Codon works in JIT and fully compiled modes. Okay, so I have this downloaded into a dot directory, codon bin codon. And I'm going to compile my version of it. Now, this is a version that was just downloaded in February of 2023 from their official binaries. And there are two different modes, at least three different modes. We can build, run, and generate documentation. We want to build, but this is by default building a debug build. --release, we want to enable compiler optimizations. Okay, and that should have built, yes, this life-codon. So let's go ahead and double check that we are doing the exact same number of iterations. For our life.py, we were doing 10,000 iterations. And for life.cpp, 10,000 iterations. So let's get the Codon one up to 10,000, recompile it, and re-execute it. Okay, we're looking at in the ballpark of 8 seconds. And if you remember, the C++ version is 0.09 seconds, which is quite a bit faster. And we're going to go ahead and also time the PyPy JITted version just to make sure that we're comparing all the same things. So at the moment, the JITted version is twice as fast as the compiled version, which doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to me. But we do have that mistake still hanging out in this code, where we have the lookup for the set of neighbors being defined inside of the function. So let's move that out and see if the compiled version can get a little bit smarter. I don't know if I'm going to have to give it a type since I'm declaring it inside the class here or not. Okay, so we were able to cut the runtime in half by moving that out. A little bit better than half, actually. So 3.5 seconds. Still nowhere near the C++ version, but finally a little bit faster than the JITted version. Interesting. But I did promise you that modulus would come up in this, and let's go ahead and take a quick look at that. You might have noted that I have this right here as I was scrolling through the code. Modulo. Codon does not use floor modulus like Python does. So if you are porting your algorithm from Python to Codon, which you might think of as Python, you have to implement your own modulus operator if you want to keep the same behavior for your wraparound index lookups. That was quite the adventure in my attempts to port this code over to compiled Python. So I just saved you all a bunch of time if you were looking at that. And just keep your eye open for that tricky modulus operator as you're moving algorithms from one programming language to another, because it's entirely possible that's going to bite you. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly.